I thought we're going to work a little bit on boundary games today. This is not very strenuous, and you can do that in any weather. And you can never do too many boundary games, so there's always something else that we can do. I'm just going to use Djin by himself today because I want to do a bit of verbal proofing, and I don't need to do that with all the dogs at the same time. So the first thing we're going to do is a really simple game, which is high value on the boundary, low value off. So I've got some hot dogs here. I'm going to give some hot dogs for being on the bed. I might do a little bit of playing around or just, you know, sitting down, getting up, playing with the food. So those are kind of some distractions that we worked on before. Maybe a little bit of mouse game. There, he knows that, he's pretty smart. And then I'm gonna give him a release. Okay, good. So he's really got a good understanding of the release cue because he moved before I tossed the treat or moved anything at all. So he gets one piece of kibble off the bed, and then we're gonna get hot dogs on the bed. And we're gonna make this a little bit more challenging because he's not a beginner. How about if I bring something out here? This is usually very interesting. Everybody wants to get on this stuff. Good boy. And I don't have to feed him every 2 seconds, you know. It's just kind of, I actually might turn my back to him and talk to the wall or some imaginary people, which is something I do in classes. This prepares my dogs to be demo dogs in classes when I just kind of move around, talk to, you know, imaginary friends. And they guys just get to hang out, or I might have to go over here and do something. And then I'll just randomly reward them for that. What if I have to pick up something over here, just check something out? Oh, very good. Sometimes I might even go out of sight for a second. There. I know he can still see me. I don't want to just leave. Good boy. We're going to do another release. This time I'm going to put the treat down first. I try to make sure that I don't move when I say my release word because that's what the dogs pair it with. Okay. Oh, didn't get that one. Okay, we'll pick it up again. Okay. Yes, good boy. So the worst thing that happens is that we get so much value on the boundary that they don't want to get up anymore. How bad is that, huh? Good boy. So I'll make sure to mix it up and add in as many distractions as you can. Add some distance, add some duration, add some distractions. But make sure to only add one of those components in at a time. Those are the three D's that we talk about when we proof behaviors. Duration, distraction, distance. And I don't know if there has to be a particular order to that, but just make sure to work on one at a time. Don't add a lot of distance, durations, and then, you know, make some big distractions up. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna work on is some verbal proofing. He does know his release word. At this point, the only one I'm using is the O and the K. Good boy. I know that's a hard one to hide. And I'm actually going to use some high value rewards off the boundary for this one. Let's just kind of gamble. And I'm going to throw out some other words. It could be totally random words. So, potatoes. Oh, good. I like that he tried that because I said something and he thought, oh, maybe that's my release cue. So I just covered it up, pick it up again. No big deal. I'll try that again. Cucumber. Okay. Good job. Very good. You notice that I am standing still when I say that. So part of it is not adding movement to my release, but the other one is also I'm adding another distraction, a proofing, which is other words that don't mean anything to him. So I'm not going to add motion to that. The alternative to standing perfectly still when we're releasing is to continuously move. It's either one or the other. What I don't want to do is start moving or move my hand as I say the word. So in agility, on the start line, what I'll use often is I'm just going to start walking at a really nice even pace. Don't change my body posture at all. And then I'm going to say the release word while I am moving. So the important part is just to not pair it with any movement, either continuous movement the whole time or standing still. I don't have really a ton of space here, so I can't demonstrate that too well. So let's use some other words. We're going to do another release with a piece of cable. How about that here? Okay. Good job. Good. So we had a low value release and high value on the boundary. This is a surefire way to build value for the boundary. And then we're going to do another strange word. And if your dogs are really twitchy and release easily, you don't have to use high value treats for this one, but I like to push it a little bit. And he's been doing this for a little while, so I'm actually gonna put it real close. Really good. So this would be an example of adding some duration, having that treat out there and not saying anything for a little while. Good. I'm going to reward for staring at it and not moving. And what kind of word are we going to use? Cauliflower. Okay. So if he doesn't respond to his release word, I'm going to pick it up and start over. I'm not going to say it twice. He's missed his opportunity. Try that again. Cauliflower. Okay. Okay. So I'm going to do some troubleshooting here. I'm going to do a little bit of a restrain. Ready? Okay. Good. Good boy. And the biggest problem we're having here is that he's got a lot of value on the boundary and doesn't want to come off because it's just too good a deal. We'll try that again. I don't know why I'm using vegetables. I just could use any word, but I seem to be drawn to using vegetables for this. Sunshine. Okay. Good boy. Very good. Good job. So here are two ways that you can work on improving the value for your dog on the boundary, and also adding some proofing to it, which is some duration, some distraction. You know, what if this just drops out of my hand? I'm a little bit clumsy. I can use my foot to cover it up as well, playing some mouse game. So because he tried to get up here, I'm not going to release him to it. What other words do we have? Thunderstorm. Okay. So we need to top up that release word again. How about agility? Okay. I was a little bit delayed. So what I'm going to do next is going to do a couple of quick releases. We're just going to use a low value for that. Okay. Ready? Okay. Sometimes if we work a lot on impulse control, which boundaries do, we can lose a little bit of the pulse. So I'm going to put in a little bit more into the pulse account. Okay. Couple of quick releases. Yes, good boy. Okay. cross. I'm gonna help you find that. Ah, no. Can you find it? There you go. That's okay. We'll find it later. Okay, so I hope this gives you some ideas on something to do in the hot weather, even if you do it outside in the yard, if you have a bit of shade. This isn't really strenuous, and yet the dogs get to work for their food and they get to use their brains. So if you have any questions about boundary games, post them in the comments. If you're watching this now or later, I can't see comments, I'm too far away here. But let me know if you're watching and if this was helpful and where's your dog at with their boundaries. And yeah, if you want to see more boundary games, let me know. We are happy to comply.